children, how are you? All are safe, I think. Okay. Today I'm inviting 9th students to listen the English first lesson. That is the snake and the mirror. So before that, I wanted to ask some questions. That is, have you seen snakes, ma? Okay, everyone, because you are worshipping snake. Okay, so now and then you are hearing about the snakes stories also. But here, how many types of the snakes? More are they, but we'll take only few examples. Number one is the hognose snake, rattlesnake, then tiger snake, cobra, king cobra, python. Python was a big one, very long body. But these are all the poisonous snakes. These are very dangerous. No one should touch. No one should touch. Why? Because it is a dangerous one. When you see the snake, what you'll do? We'll search for the stick to kill the snake. Why? Because it is the dangerous one. Okay. But here we'll enter our lesson. Okay. So the snake and the mirror. Here we are going to see one doctor. The doctor went to practice in one place. He took one rented room. That only one single room. But here we are going to see the room was full of the rats. Full of the rats all day. There was no ceiling, no fan, no electricity, nothing was there. But what the doctor will do? He was keeping one kerosene lamp and one cot, one chair, one table, and before the table one mirror also there. But here the person feeling unhappy because there was no air. Sometimes he was opening the windows to let the air to breathe. Sometimes he went out to take the air like that he was doing. But suddenly the person heard a familiar sound. What was the familiar sound? We don't know. When he heard the familiar sound, he was looking up. Why? Because that was not the ceiling, no ma. So under the beams, the rats may be wandering, and familiar sound also coming from the top of the ceiling. So it was so horrible one. But anyhow, the person was managing. But everyone, though he was a doctor, he was afraid of the familiar sound. Why? Because everybody knows. Because that was the familiar one. What was the creature? We don't know. But here the person, or the doctor, what he was doing? The house was not electrified. It was a small rented room. I had just set up medical practice and my earnings were meager. Meager means a little quantity. Small quantity. So he was earning only little money, then that about 60 rupees in my suitcase, along with some shirt and dhoti. I also possessed means belongs to me, that is my own, possessed one solitary black coat which I was then wearing. No one then he was wearing the white coat because he was a doctor. No, so that's what, he belongs to only one shirt and some money. So he was earning a little money. What he was doing? I took off my black coat, white shirt and not so white vest and hung them up. So he took off the coat and he hanged near the mirror. What we'll do after going home? We are removing our dresser and wearing the nighties or something, no, like that. The doctor also doing like that. I opened the two windows in the room. It was an outer room with one wall facing the open yard. It had a tiled roof with long supporting gables then rested on the beam over the wall. Beams are there, that was not the ceiling one. There was no ceiling. There was a regular traffic of rats. The rats are wandering under the beam. They are the friends of the doctor maybe. Okay. Then I made my bed and pulled it close to the wall. So when the rats are wandering under the beam, what the person was doing? He was taking the bed close to the wall. Then I got up and went out to the veranda for a little air. But the wind god seemed to have taken time off. So when he was suffering a lot with the rats and no air, he went out to take the air. Outside also there was no air. I went back into the room and sat down on the chair. I opened the box beneath the table and took out a book. So again he entered the room, he took one book, because he was a doctor, no, he was not reading unnecessary books. What book he was reading? The book name was Materia. Materia Medica. Because he was a doctor, he was reading the Materia Medica book. I opened it at the table on which stood the lamp and a large mirror. A small comb lay beside the mirror. So on the table, what are there, ma? A comb also there. Comb and mirror also there. He opened the book. There was no light. He opened the book and took the answer, saw the comb and mirror before the table. Then one feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near. I took a look. So when there was a mirror, what we'll do? Boys or girls or ladies or gentlemen, why will we see our face is clear or not? When we go out, is there a nicely or not? Like that, this doctor also giving the importance to the his beauty. How is my face? So how to comb like this? Like that, he stood before the mirror and thinking about the lifestyle. See? Then I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. Boys, we have to say boys are handsome and girls are beautiful. Girls are beautiful. So this doctor always thinking, always giving importance to the face value. How is my face? I want to look more beautiful, more handsome. Like that, the doctor was looking at the mirror and what he was doing? I was unmarried. He was not the married one. He was unmarried. He was a bachelor. So still he wants to give the more beauty to his face. He wants to do. He was looking at the mirror. So not only girls, boys also looking at the mirror to see the face. So I was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up that comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Again heard that sound from above. When he was standing before the mirror, again he heard the sound. Second time. First time he heard the familiar sound, but he didn't think about the familiar sound. When he was looking at the mirror, again second time also, he looked out. Why? Because a familiar sound. A familiar sound came from the under the beam. So again he looked out. Then I took a close at my face in the mirror. Again he went to go through near the mirror. I made an important decision. What is the important decision? He took a decision. Decision means he decided. Again, he went near the mirror. He took a strong decision. The decision was, I would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. He was thinking, yes, still I want to look very handsome. And so he wanted to shave again and again. He wants to keep a small mustache to look very handsome. So he was a doctor, he was unmarried one, he was a bachelor. So he had that idea, he was that gene. Why? Because I was a doctor, I have to look very handsome. Then I was, after all, a bachelor and doctor. I was a bachelor and a doctor. Okay, ma? Till I finish tomorrow, I'll continue. Now, I wanted to give some meanings. I want to give some meaning. That is, full-blooded. Full-blooded means strong. Who is the strong here? The familiar sound was the strong. Then tail means story. T-A-I-L, tail means all the animals having the tail. T-A-L, tail means story. Then opposite of familiar, unknown. Doctor heard a familiar sound from the beams of the place. Then solitary means a single room. The doctor living in the single room. Then okay, these are the meanings, and so after the lesson some more I'll give. Full-blooded means strong. The animal python, the animal was the very strong one. Tail means story. Tail is the, all the animals having the tail. Familiar opposite to unknown. So, have you understood about the doctor's mentality? How is the room? How he was living? What are the things he had? Then, everyone, you be careful. Up to here, I'll stop. Tomorrow, I'm going to continue. Okay, thank you.